G'day mates, Heartybbq here. We're going to be playing some Zoo and grinding for gold. Now, Cuse of Naxxramus is on its way, and I'm going to be talking while playing Zoo, you know, to maximize time efficiency here, how we can go about getting the most out of our gold to save up for Cuse of Naxxramus. So, the pricing has been released, 700 gold per wing, but you'll get the first wing free. That gives you an extra head start from the day of release if you want to pay with gold to get into each of the wings. So really, not a whole lot of pressure to get that gold together, especially considering quests are going to be coming every day if you complete all your quests. Also, make sure when you've got your quests coming that you send back any quest that is worth 40 gold. So if you click the little X in the corner of your quests that are worth 40 gold, you get to re-roll them. You want to be re-rolling them for 60 gold, 70 gold, 100 gold instead. I think it's 70 gold? I don't remember. So that you can really be getting the most out of it. So to get 700 gold, if you're getting, say, an average, even if you're only averaging 50 gold a day, plus I guess you'd get some gold for the games that you play. Let's say 60 gold per day. So, you know, it's going to take... 11 days? 12 days. 12 days to get 700, barring nothing else. That's barring no extra quests. I think that's even undercounting the number of, the amount of gold you get from number of games that you play just to get those quests going. So it's really not too much of a hassle. What I'm doing here this season, so you can see I'm down at lowly number 9. I'm not even concerned about my ranking this season because Cuse of Naxxramus is going to hit. I'm going to be playing that. I'm not going to have time for laddering. And it takes a lot of commitment to really push those ranks from 5 upwards. So it's not going to happen for me this season. So even better, I'm going to be playing ranked. And playing Zoo is a really good choice because it's fast, but not only is it fast, but you know whether you're going to win or lose very quickly. So by about turn 4, turn 5, it's pretty clear who's going to win the game. So in this case, you know, we're up to turn 3. It's looking pretty clear that it's in my favor. We could get a consecration here, which could upset the apple cart, but barring that, it's already in hand. I'm playing, and there's the consecration. Alright, so I'm playing a list that is good against other quick decks that don't beat down too quickly. But yeah, you know, it's kind of mindless. So, 700 gold for the wings. It's a little bit more than I was expecting, but still 700. Do you need a blessing? It's reasonable, I guess. Only that it's, you know, it's not really... It's not too difficult to get the gold. Oh, really? Shieldmaster. Alright, I'm playing this game wrong. It's not that hard to get the gold together. So, it's value, I guess. Alright, so I'm playing out dudes. Alright, we're gonna make some trades. So still hooking this one, but if you don't care about rank, you can just concede as soon as it's looking like you don't really have much of a chance to win. That's really going to save you some time on the ladder as well. And keeping your rank low, you'll have, you know, less able opponents, which will make things a bit easier as well. You do. Well, there's the second consecration. All right. Okay, again, need some top decks here. So, you're better off in the ladder if you're staying at low ranks. Some people are going to be already up too high, I suppose. But if you're at low ranks, you want to stay at low ranks. Much better that than casual, where you're going to have opponents of any skill level all the way up to, you know, 1 to 3 rank, which you really don't want to be facing. So those players... at that high ranks, if they just want to fulfill their quest for the day but don't want to risk their ranking, we'll jump in those games.
Reporting for duty.
Things are looking sketchy. Looking sketchy for me. So I might have lost this game. I think I only need to see about one more turn. So I don't think I've got it here. I'm going to have a 1-5 shield bearer, I guess. Really relying on tech deck. So the only thing at the top end in this list of zoo is the Doomguard. Alright, there's Tyrion. So this game, well, I've got another owl, I guess. Your faith in the light. Not even an Ironbeak owl gets me out of this one, so that's fine. I ain't even mad, bro. You win this time. So now I can talk more generally about the gold versus money system in Hearthstone. That it's I like it that it values time, and I think it gets the balance quite fair. Certainly, if the balance is too far in favor one way or the other, it's not going to work for a game. You certainly don't want players to get inordinate amounts of gold for spending, you know, just a couple of dollars. As quite a number of apps for iPhone tend to do. They'll give you 10 hours, 100 hours, 1,000 hours worth of gold at you for a dollar. That doesn't happen in Hearthstone. So it's much more balanced that if you want to spend gold, you're giving yourself a time advantage, so you can shortcut yourself. And if you're impatient, if you know, just want to jump into that next arena and you don't have the gold, or you want to jump into the next wing of Naxxramus before you've saved up the gold, you can do that. And it's pretty reasonable. Reasonably priced, I feel. And by the same token, you don't... If you're not going to spend any money ever, and, you know, I tend not to spend money on Hearthstone as well, that you don't feel like you're the players that just buy their way through the game are getting an unfair advantage, because I don't feel that way at all. The game's really not pay to play. It's, you know, it's either you can commit with your time or commit with money, or some balance in between, and that feels pretty good, I'd say. All right, so this game. So as I've built my list to really take care of other zoo lists. So two ways that you can build a zoo to take it out in the mirror: either lower your curve and drop in Elven Archers. You don't want a Harvest Golem, so you still want all of the build up guys. Alright, I've got good choices here. I think Dark Iron Dwarf is still the best, though. Gets me... well, 2, 4... it's about the same. It leaves me the options of what I want to put Defender of Arcs on later. Alright.
I'll give it a
shot. The other option is to go the Divine route. Divine Shield guys along with Blood Knight is another strong option, but I like this a little better. Hellfire, you say? Okay, well, good thing I went... well, could have saved some things from Hellfire, I guess. But this is... Hellfire, not a common choice. And I'm not sure it's good.
My shield for
I'm fairly confident that Hellfire is probably not great. My opponent pretty much wiped my board, but he's still so far behind. It'd be nice if I could end the turn at some point. Duh. Let's pause this. Oh, unpause. Wow, okay. My opponent just conceded, so... Right, well, that's about all I'm going to say. I'm going to get back to the grind. No need to be recording it, I guess, unless people just want to see some games. I suppose I should do that as well, but when I'm in a more serious mood rather than just grind for gold. I'll leave you guys to it, guys and gals, though mostly guys. Good luck in your grind for gold. Cuse of Naxxramus hopefully coming next week, the week after. July, they've said, they've promised it will be out in July. And when it hits, I'll be making videos. So, look forward to that. Until next time, thanks for watching.